This game has a screen reader feature. This setting can be changed, along with rate and volume.
Hello there, welcome to my channel, and also welcome to Until Dawn. This is the remastered version, just came out. Playing this on pretty much like right when it's releasing. It's about 10 p.m. In the evening. And so, I mean, I've been waiting for this for a while. Found out that they're doing a remake, or not remake, a remastered version for the PS5 on this maybe like a month ago or so. And I saw like videos of it. Man, it looks so good. Like, updated visuals and shit like that. I don't know what else they've done, but the visuals alone are really what did it for me. Like, oh, okay, I'm gonna play this. So, I've never actually played the first one before. I have seen it. I've watched it. Watched, you know, other YouTubers play it. But me personally, I've never played it. Though, I am a big fan of this game. And so with that, let's get into this, shall we? Let's go ahead and go into the settings here really quickly. I mean, just hold on. Like, look at that. Like, the facial, dude, it looks so good. It looks way better than the 2014 when it first released. So like a whole 10 years if I'm not mistaken, since the original came out on the PS4, and I'm so excited for it, man. You have no idea. All right, I think we're good to go. So, you know, I've said what I've said. I love the original, and I can't wait to actually play this for the first time for you guys. Hopefully you guys will enjoy it. And with that, you know, grab your snacks, grab your drinks, grab whatever it is you may like, sit down, and let's do this, shall we? New story. Starting a new story will overwrite your current progress and access to the episode menu if unlocked. Also lose any collectibles. Yeah. Whatever. Let's just get into it, man. I'm so excited. It's October as well. It's spooky season. Ooh. We're getting a recap of a good movie, The Butterfly Effect. Essentially, any choices that you make will affect the future. Some shit like that. Choose your actions carefully. Oh, dude, look at it. Dude, it looks so good already. What? Hey, buddy. At moments in the story, you will need to stay still. Hold the controller still and don't panic. Try it now. You got it. And I'm holding still. If you move too much, there may be consequences. Oh, trust me. I know. I know how this works. I am not moving. I did it, baby. Facial visuals look really, really good. That's kind of like what sold me on this, on the remastered
Jeez,
version.
Josh, once again, brother, you've outdone us all.
It's just me or their voice is quiet. And in like the original, it was just like super dark and like had this like overwhelmingly blue, like, I don't know, filter over the entire game. It was weird. Here now it seems in better lighting, at least. Oh, that's already a plus. Dude, he looks so good.
I can't believe you actually did this.
Don't you guys think this is a little bit cruel?
Oh, come on. She deserves it.
Sorry, I'm gonna have to pause here. The just seems a little quiet, doesn't it? Maybe that's just me. No, everything's bumped up to 100. Oh well. I'll probably just let's do that. Enable midnight mode to normalize audio output? What does that mean? Whatever. Let's do it. All right. I don't know. I'll fix it in editing.
She has a huge crush on me.
Hannah's been making moves on him. I'm just looking out for my girl, Em.
Just because he's class prez doesn't mean he belongs to everyone. Mike is my man.
I'm not anybody's man.
Whatever you say, darling.
Just forewarning too for everybody. If you don't know this game, there are a lot of jump scares from what I remember from the original. So Just forewarning you right now. Damn, Chris, you got fucked up. We're actually playing. Oh, let's go, dude. Look around. I don't like the black bars. Oops. Is there a way to change that? Hold on. Addition, no. The video can help remove black bars. Will this help? Oh, there we go. Oh, that's way better. Oh, thank you. I get it, you know? Kind of like a movie, but please. That's fun. Alright. Yeah, that looks way better. Why is it? Hold on. I'm so sorry. It's just the film grain. Yeah, there we go. Yes. Oh, that looks better. That looks way better. Anne, it's been fun hanging out with you. No one gets me like you do. Come find me later. I'll be waiting. Mike.
Oh my god. What did our naive sister get herself into now?
Is there supposed to be like music going on right now? Hold on. Fuck it. I'll just keep. Yeah. Whatever. I don't care. I thought they would have put like, you know, some of their own music. I don't know. Whatever. Something definitely seemed off right there, like a montage, but there's no music. That was just weird. Sorry for all the pausing. Just trying to, you know. I want this to be a good experience, not just for me, but for all of you guys as well. For my two viewers. No, I'm kidding. Two viewers, I mean me on my phone and on my computer.
Mike.
Hey, Hannah.
I got your note.
Glad you can make it. Maybe we should start with a little, you know, making out and see where it goes from there.
Mm-hmm. I saw this. This opening was kind of fucked up.
She's taking her shirt off. Hannah, hey, don't. It's
just a stupid prank, okay?
I'm sorry, Hannah. This all got out of hand.
Are jerks. You know that? Hannah!
I wonder, is it? Did they redo their voices, or is it just they're using the same voices? Gonna find people. Fuck Josh. Josh is too fucked up.
Where's she going?
It's fine. She just can't take a joke.
It was just a prank, Han.
It sounds like the original voices. Well, like from the first game.
So, should we go after her?
You know, I kind of think you're the last person she wants to see right now, Mike.
Still, go look
Hannah!
For her. Yes. Oh.
Hannah.
Let's not talk about that, shall we? The footprints. There we go. How are you guys doing? Hopefully you guys are doing well. Anything, you know, interesting going on? As for me, well, of course, I'm playing this. It being October.
Hannah?
Oh, fuck, dude. See what I mean? I get jump scares and shit. Ugh. It's okay. I kinda know what's gonna happen. Cause you know, I've actually seen this played like a few times actually. You know, saying all the different butterfly effects, all the different endings and shit. Come on. But this being, you know, a remaster and everything, I don't know what they're going to change, how it's going to change, you know. Come on. Yeah, this is new. Oh, we got QTEs, baby. Let's do fast. We got this. I'm good at QTEs. Let's go with the footprints. Hey, buddy.
Jesus, fuck, shit.
Damn it, Hannah. Where are you?
Damn.
Hannah. Oh my god, you must be freezing. Here, take my coat. I'm such an idiot. I'm so dumb. Anna? Beth?
Better run. The predator's coming after you. Damn. Get your ass up. Oh, great.
Jesus Christ. No. No. Fuck. No.
Shit.
Hold on.
Sorry, Hannah. I gotta look out for myself. Great. Dang. Got a new definition for break your back. Is it? Yes, Stromane.
Before we begin, there are a few things I need to make sure you understand. You see, no one can change what happened last year. The past is beyond our control. You have to accept this in order to move forward. But there is freedom in this revelation. Everything
really
you do, every decision you make from now on will open doors to the future. I want you to remember this. I want you to remember this as you play your game. Every single choice will affect your fate and the fate of those around you. So, you have committed to commence with this game. This is significant. And I want to help you see it through. Sometimes these things can be a little scary, even terrifying, but I'm here to make sure that no matter how upsetting things may get, you will always find a way to work through it. Hmm? All right. We will start with a simple exercise. Could you please pick up a card? And I want you to look at the picture on the other side and tell me what you feel about it.
Okay.
It is essential you answer honestly in order to get the most out of this experience.
You got it, baby. Can I? Oh. Ew, Scarecrow. Okay.
So, how did that picture make you feel? Remember, be honest.
It actually kind of makes me happy, because just like the simple countryside, right? Just like, it looks nice, like honestly.
Oh, that's good. In what way did it make you happy?
Yeah, it's like, it's peaceful.
Oh. Interesting. That's interesting. So, would it make you happy to spend the whole week here?
Yeah, actually. By myself? Fuck yeah, I would. Are you kidding me? Getting away from everything and everyone? Dude, that sounds nice.
That this cottage was haunted.
Haunted? In, like, what way? Are we, like, poltergeists or, like, groans and shit? Either way, I wouldn't really care.
Level-headed response. But everyone is frightened of something. I wonder what it is that does frighten you. I really do.
Jump scares. I hate that shit, man.
Sorry, we're out of time. Let's investigate that in our next session, shall we?
You know what I am afraid of? Heights. I fucking hate heights, dude. Like, even climbing, like, a ladder. Climbing up and, like, getting to the top and, like... The ladder will be shaking because I'm... Dude, I hate heights. I hate heights so goddamn much. I know people are, like, arachnophobic and shit. Spiders don't really get to me. You know what, like, you know what, insect really freaks me out? Fucking centipedes, man. Ugh. Just thinking about it. Oh, I get like a chill down my spine. Just thinking about centipedes. Ooh. I don't know what it is. Like, all their legs and the way they like slither and shit. Ooh, dude. Which is weird because, like, snakes don't bother me. I know my dad, like, hates snakes. Like, they freak him out. But snakes for me don't really do anything. I think snakes are kind of cool. But yeah, like, it's a good, interesting topic. What are you guys, like, afraid of? Another thing, like, the dark. I know, kind of childish, but yeah, like the dark. I am actually kind of afraid of the dark. If it's like pitch black, like, can't really do anything about that. But like, if it's like, if you can like see just a tiny bit, and like it's just dark, I don't know, just get kind of uneasy about it.
The dreadful tragedy that took place on Mount Washington. Sheriff Annie Klein, who's in charge of the investigation.
Thanks for having me, Marty.
Listeners, an update on Hannah and Beth Washington, the twins who are still missing.
1 year ago tonight, the Washington girls left the safety of their parents' lodge and headed out into
the snowstorm. I don't know why it's like Jerry like that.
No. There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently unknown. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. He had warned them against pursuing their
history. Think it has anything to do with the motion blur?
The land was sacred to his forefathers.
You know, there is still the old sanatorium on the mountain. Could
maybe. Maybe I'll have to turn on the motion blur.
The grounds, but the girls themselves couldn't have made it that far.
Something about that mountain seems to breed tragic events.
More than you know, Marty.
Well, thank you for joining us, Annie. With all the Washingtons tonight, their son Josh, on this, the anniversary of the mysterious disappearance of Hannah and Beth Washington.
Well, hello, friends and fans. All right, let's do that again. All right. Well, hello, friends and fans. It's beyond awesome to have you guys all back this year. First off, I gotta say, I'm super excited to welcome all my pals back to the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway. So,
I always thought it was kind of crazy that they got Rami Malek to do this. It was kind of cool.
The elephant in the room for a second. I know you're all probably worried about me, and I know it's gonna be tough on all of us going back after what happened last year, but... I just want you all to know, it means so much to me that we're doing this, and that I know it would mean so much to Hannah and Beth that we're all still here together, you know, thinking of them. I really want to spend some quality time with each and every one of you, and just share some moments that we'll never forget for the sake of my sisters, and, you know. Okay, so, let's party like we're fucking porn stars, okay? Make this one trip we will never forget, all right?
So weird, it like, it's yes! Like, it's like jittering a lot, really. I know this game just came out, but come on. you know what I mean? Chapter 1, Friendship. 10 hours until dawn. They said it. Run the post credits. Hey, buddy. Yeah, like in the original, this was like, I don't know why, but it was like, just had this weird blue like tint over it. So I'm really glad that it's actually sunshine and not like, it looks good. It looks really, really good, and it looks great. It looks awesome already. Sam, Hannah's best friend, diligent, considerate, and brave. Let me turn on the motion blur. Put it at low. Maybe medium. Fuck it.
Someone there?
Alright, that seems to kinda fix it. Path to cable car station. Yeah, I do like this because in the original it seemed like it was already dark, right? And since it's like almost until dawn, it would make sense that it would be like 5 or maybe like 7 p.m. right now, right? I mean, 10 hours until dawn. Dawn is like, you can barely, like, the sun isn't peaking, but it's just about to, you know? Maybe, like, 6 in the morning, something like that.
What?
Climb up. Okay.
Damn it.
What's this? Yo, how do I get there again? I can do this. I'm good at QTEs. I played God of War, the originals. Speaking of, how do you guys like the new God of Wars? I thought they were great. I thought they were fan-fucking-tastic. Those were a lot of fun.
Aww.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, little fella. You hungry? Huh?
I'm not moving. Not moving. We're gonna get jump scared by another deer. I think so. It's a big ass total. Yeah, so I'm off. I have 3 days off from work, so I'm just enjoying this. Can play this all night long. I could probably finish it tonight if I wanted to. We'll see. Let's actually read this. Indigenous people and butterfly prophecies. Tribes who once lived in these mountains believe that butterflies carry dreams and prophecies of possible futures. The color of the butterfly indicated the nature of the prophecy. Black butterflies prophesize the dreamer's death. Oh. Danger. Red butterflies warned of dangerous events. Brown butterflies foretold of tragedy affecting friends. Yellow offered visions to help and guide. White brought dreams of luck and good fortune. What is that green one? I actually can't read that well. Unsure of what the green one entails. So here's a cable car.
Hello?
What's this? It's a vehicle? There's two vehicles. There's no run button. Ah, it's Emily.
Emily.
Hold on. That's a heart. I gotta see what that says. Chris for Josh. And a handprint. So Chris is here. The past is beyond our control.
Wow,
why is it written like that?
Here? Chris, you here?
I'm not gonna interact with that just yet. Nor that backpack. Because I want to explore. Dude, it looks so good.
Oh man, look at that.
Clue one. That was posted in July of 1998. Kind of crazy. What is this? That's a grill. Looks like it hasn't been used in forever.
Okay then.
A shooting range? That's weird. Hello? Is there really nobody here? Chris, why is your backpack here?
That's here.
Not in the bag, are you?
Hello? What do we have here?
I don't like snooping through people's shit.
Maybe I should look around Chris's stuff.
Chris?
Sam, hey, you made it.
What up, my dog? Has a crush on Ashley. Loyal, protective, and humorous.
Oh, so I found something kind of amazing.
What?
I'm not going to tell you. You got to see for yourself. Come on, it's this way.
Where?
Right around here. Going to blow your mind.
Hi, Chris. I don't know who my favorite character is. Probably Chris. And like, you know, all the characters go through some shit, man.
Ta-da!
So,
pretty rad, right?
At first, you know, you may not like a person, but then
come on, look at these
character
beauties.
Development.
Beauties is not the word that comes to mind. Why is this even here?
What do you mean?
What the hell is a shooting range doing at the base of a ski lodge?
That's what I said. Kind of weird.
Have you met Josh's dad?
Yeah.
He thinks he's like Grizzly Adams or something. Want to try?
No, yeah, you go ahead, Grizzly.
All right. Here goes.
Crack shot, baby.
All right, I'm bad. I'm a badass.
I'm gonna go ahead and guess it was a wild case of beginner's luck.
Nah, I don't think so, girl.
Well, anybody and their brother could shoot a bottle that big, that close.
Oh yeah, what about this squirrel, huh? Look at it, he's got a spotlight on it and everything. I'm not gonna shoot a fucking squirrel. What the fuck? That's
nice shot.
That's cruel.
Your ass just got
it's
stacked.
Like some psychopathic shit.
Hey, sharpshooter, our ride's coming.
Wait, I'm just getting the hang of this.
Come on, Chris, the cable car.
Rats with bushy tails. Our plan is Chris. Let's go. I like Chris. I like Mike as well. I don't know.
Man, it is.
I like all the characters in this.
It's definitely that
they
weird
did a good job.
Back up here after a whole year.
Yeah, I swear. Hey, that's weird. Door's locked.
Yeah. Josh wanted us to keep it locked to keep people out.
He said that? What people?
I don't know. He said they found people sleeping in the station one time.
That's creepy. Real gentleman.
I really like the lighting. They did a good job so far. I know we're sub an hour into this game, but even still, like, just feels so good, and it looks so good as well.
So beautiful in the day, but at night just feels menacing, like a sleeping giant.
You gonna publish? What a crazy place to set up house. I mean, no matter how rich you are.
You're not so rich.
Hotel and sanatorium for a healthy body and mind. That's not good.
Your pretty poem. The sleeping giant of Blackwood Flint.
Wait. I wasn't paying attention. What happened?
Your pretty poem. The sleeping giant of Blackwood Flint.
Finally, you coming?
Yeah, well, I was gonna stay here and catch some Z's, but okay. Just like going to the prom.
Here we go.
Right. Adventure begins.
This was the right thing to do.
What?
You know, getting everyone together on the anniversary. I mean, Josh seemed really pumped about us all doing something, didn't he?
Yeah, no, he definitely did. I haven't seen him so excited about something in forever.
Good, good. It's hard to tell with him, and I'm kind of worried.
No, it was a good idea.
I hope everyone else feels the same way.
We're all here, aren't we?
Thanks, bro. Good talk.
You know what? Let's just stop talking about what happened and enjoy the trip.
You know what? You're right.
You know how Josh and I met?
No.
Third grade. Josh sat in the back of the room. I sat in the front. We didn't even know each other existed. But the kid sitting next to Josh started strap snapping the training bra on the girl in front of him. So the teacher made him move to the front, where I was sitting.
Okay, so?
So I got moved to the back.
And
next to Josh. That's how we met. I mean, and became friends to this day.
Match made in heaven.
If it weren't for the fact that Jeannie Simmons hit puberty like 3 years early, and on that day decided to wear a low-cut shirt that showed off a training bra, who knows? You could be riding in this cable car alone. Right now. Or talking to some other person entirely. Boom. Butterfly effect.
Sure. Let's go with that. This fucking bitch. I know I said that I didn't really dislike anybody, but there was one. It'd be this bitch.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy. New people. Time to meet and greet.
Great. I can see them. That didn't scare me.
Are you guys having a really weird stroke?
We're stuck in this stupid thing.
Can you please let us out? Pretty please?
Oh my god. I thought we were goners. Another 10 minutes in there and I would have chewed off my own leg.
Oh, sick, Chris.
Look, got a lot of meat on my bones. It's all muscle down here.
Yeah, right.
Hey!
well, what do we have
Chris.
Here? My goodness! Seems that someone has a little crush on our good friend and dear class president Michael Monroe.
Chris.
And what kind of sizzling erotica might our Jessica be capable of imagining? I wonder.
Give that back, you tool.
Tool and die. That's my motto.
Oh, you're such an idiot. Maybe nosy Nancy shouldn't go nosing around in other people's nostrils.
Yeah, I try not to do that, as a rule.
Come on, Jess, you can tell us. You can totally keep secrets.
Whatever.
Sure you can.
You'll figure it out eventually.
All right, let's just get up to the lodge already. It's getting tired of all this nature and junk.
You guys go ahead. I'm just gonna wait here for a bit. See who else is coming.
You mean Mike?
What? I mean, you know, whoever.
Uh-huh. Sam?
Did you see this view? I mean, holy cow. Sometimes I forget to just stop and take it all in.
That's what she said.
Seriously, couldn't they have built the lodge, like, right where the cable car ends?
Now, I know Emily's a bitch and everything, right? First and foremost, yes. However, I think you'll come to... Well, I don't know. I personally like Emily as well. She, man, but man, he goes through some shit, dog. Fucking crazy.
I don't think it would have been like as pretty, you know?
They changed Matt. Matt used to look different. I was trying to figure out, like, who the hell is this? And then I was like, oh, it's Matt. I wonder why. Is it a new actor? Like I said, I don't really know much about this. I don't know if they re-recorded lines or redid anything for this remaster, or if they just kept everything kind of the same, but just updated visuals and shit. So, I'm going into this, like, essentially blind.
And where's the bellboy when you need one?
Bellboy? Excuse me?
Getting chills.
We're almost there.
No, I mean, getting kind of creeped out.
Oh, yeah.
Gonna be weird seeing everyone up here again.
Definitely not gonna feel like a regular party. I mean, what do you think?
Jesus!
Very funny, fucking bitch.
You guys.
Michael.
You really, really should have seen your faces right there. Dude, I almost clocked you just now.
Nice one.
Michael, you're a jerk.
Come on. Guys, we're all friends here, right? No need for violence, just a little harmless fun. We're up in the woods, it's spooky. Come on, let's get into the spirit of things.
The spirit of things? Seriously, what's wrong with you?
I'm just trying to lighten the mood.
It's winter.
Don't be like that.
Like what?
The way you're being. You always get like this. Michael. I'm just gonna lay it out, otherwise this whole weekend's gonna suck ass for everyone. This is super awkward, and we all know it. Let's just acknowledge it now and move on, okay?
Matt.
I hear you, man. I get it. I don't want to make this weird.
Cool. So we're good?
All good.
You guys gonna make out now?
Oh my god, totally. We're so gonna make out. No. Seriously, I'm gonna go check on the cable car back down the trail.
All right. See you, man.
See ya. All right. See ya.
See ya.
Crap.
Oh, dude, I'm so
hey, could you
so excited for this,
the rest of the
dude.
Way?
The bags?
Yeah, all the bags.
Why?
I need to go find Sam.
Okay.
Could
Sorry,
I have done
I
that?
I really need to
like
go
earlier?
Find her. I totally forgot I needed to talk to her before we get all the way up there.
This really can't wait. We're almost there.
It's important, Matt. Please.
Fine.
All right. Fine. If it's so important, I guess I can pack horse it the rest of the way. But you owe me one.
Excuse me?
Well, then we're even, at least.
I'll think about it.
You think about it.
See you up there, sweetie. Thank you.
Oh, be careful. Now their jump scare's coming. I'm forewarning you. Ashley has a crush on Chris. Oh, that's cute. They both have crushes on each other and they don't know how to tell each other. Another jump scare.
Whoa, hello. Somebody's getting a little friendly. Not in the friend zone kind of way. I might need to check the expiration date on their big breakup.
Oh! Told you.
Hey, whoa. Sorry there. Sorry about that, Ash. I didn't mean to scare
Jeez
you.
Louise,
well,
Matt.
I did mean to scare you, sort of scare you, but not like for real scare you.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Hey, wow. Man, I'm really sorry, Ash. Damn.
It's okay. It's fine. It's fine.
What are you looking at? See anything juicy with that thing?
You know what? Go ahead.
Sure. Go ahead. Knock yourself out, I guess.
All right. Oh, son of a bitch. Seriously, Emily? What the hell, man?
Hey, listen, it's probably nothing.
Nothing, you think?
Well, yeah.
Is it ever just nothing with him? Ever?
I don't know.
God damn it.
Matt.
Ashley, not a big fan of Ashley, if I'm being honest. Let's check our phone. 'Cause we're millennials.
Oh, you did not just do that.
Put your hands where I can see them. We've got you, Sam.
But who am I to retaliate? What choice do I, a supple young rebel girl, have but to surrender to the strapping military guard come to take me into custody?
Well, I don't know when you put it like that. Hey! Hey! Oh! Great. Hey, you know that?
Where are you hiding, little chickie?
Oh!
Ah.
Hey!
Oh shit! I didn't see that one. We're not gonna hit a bird. Come on, man.
Hello. Come on. Hey, Mike.
Got me.
Boom shot. Hey, buddy. Sometimes doing that is the right thing to do. I see you over there. But as the game suggests, I will do nothing.
Oh,
Take that, bitch.
Find you just.
And then what?
Oh,
no more.
Oh, oh yeah. Oh more. Oh, you're going down. Gotcha. It's done. Done city.
So did I go down?
I don't think so.
I think you'd know so if I did.
All right. All right.
My. So are we calling it my favor then?
Your worthy opponent, Miss Jessica, the Snowball Queen.
Okay, that sounds vaguely dirty.
My lady.
Oh, oh, come on.
Ah! Oh, okay. Okay, you're really gonna get it.
What am I gonna get?
Well, I can think of at least one thing.
Yeah.
But you'll have to wait until later. We should get up to the lodge.
Yeah. It's so nice out here, though. Pretty breathtaking.
I mean, I could stay out here for pretty much ever, provided I was making out with you the whole time.
Just making out?
Quote, unquote.
Well, I think we might freeze to death somewhere in between those quotes.
Yeah.
Who's that? Hey, buddy. My favorite man.
Hello again. And how are we feeling?
Feeling pretty good, actually. How are you doing?
It seems we hardly scratched the surface in our last session, so let's go a little bit deeper this time.
Mm-hmm. You got for
this
me.
This time, we're going to try to understand the root of your anxiety. Now pick up that book, turn the pages. You will see a set of pictures and symbols. I want you to identify which image in each set makes you the most anxious.
Okay. The most anxious, you say? I don't know. Typically men really kind of worry me, because you never, I mean, might sound sexist, but men scare me more just because of what they're capable of than what women are capable of. You know what I mean? So would I have to say men? This one's a tough one. Crowds. I don't know. I think planes really make me more anxious than crowds of people. Oh, yeah. You already know. I fucking hate heights, dude. Snakes or rats scare me. I don't know. Not really scared of either one, but it's more about what makes me feel more anxious, and I'm more anxious about snakes than I am of rats, so I'm gonna have to say snakes. Doesn't he slam the desk at one point? Guns or knives? Typically, I feel like knives scare me more because it's more like up close and personal, right? I think that's why I like the horror movies with like slashers and like Michael Myers and Jason, Friday the 13th, because they're chasing you down and they gotta get close. Like, sure, they could grab a gun and just, you know, shoot you, big whoop, but knives, ooh, you gotta get up nice and close to them, right? That's just my personal feeling. Yeah, I'm gonna have to say cockroaches. Ew. I don't really like. None of these really scare me. If I had to choose, I'd say clones. They're hiding behind a facade, right? Gore or crows? I don't know. My horror movies, I like gore. I think I'm gonna have to say crows because they actually like resemble something, right? Usually they're like symbolized with like death and stuff. I'm gonna have to go with crows.
Did that startle you?
No, because I actually knew you were gonna slam the desk at some point.
Don't be nervous. Try to speed up a bit. The more you rely on your instincts, the more honest your answers will be, and the more enlightening you will find this experience.
Okay. Cockroaches. Crows. I like zombies, so I'm gonna say clowns again. Wolves? No. Crows again. Storms? No. Crows? Yes.
This is very interesting. Thank you for answering so diligently.
Anything for you, Doug. You're my favorite.
Clowns and crows. The sun combination sounds like a good Friday night. Well, I'm afraid once again we're out of time, but I promise we'll talk again very soon.
Chapter 2, Jealousy. 9 hours until dawn.
Every time I climb it.
Oh yeah? It feels the same to me.
Actually, right there, I am going to stop it. Stop the recording. Because I want to go ahead and pump this baby out. Nice and ready for all of you. Hopefully, what I'm hoping for is that I'll be able to play this, and I'm gonna keep playing this, right? And I don't know if I want to do two videos a day or just keep it to like one video a day. I know this game can be quite long and lengthy, depending on like, you know, if you're searching for collectibles and trying to go through everything, which I'm not going to be actively searching for collectibles, but I do want to kind of like explore, see what's changed about everything, see what maybe if they added anything or like took some stuff out and stuff like that. So during different parts of the game I will be exploring some. So if I'm not mistaken, the first game was like maybe 8 hours, 8 to 10 hours, I think. Might have been shorter. Might have been six hours, 5 or 6, maybe. I don't know. But it is a lengthy game, so we're gonna stop it right there, and I will decide whether I want like two videos a day, or just keep it to one a day. It being Halloween and everything, you know, spooky season and everything, I want to keep in the spirit of like horror games and stuff. Later on in a couple weeks, I think in 2 weeks, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I think it's 2 weeks. There's another video game that is not horror based, but I am very, very looking forward to, and I hope so, and I hope you guys are as well. So with that, I will see you guys later. Johnny.